Hello students, myself Sheetal Sawan. I am lecturer at Praveen Patil College of Diploma Engineering and Technology. So today we are going to start with chapter number 4, that is flow measurement of the subject name Mechanical Engineering Measurement. Learning outcomes. So after completion of this video, student will be able to understand measurement of flow, flow measuring techniques, inferential type flow meter, variable head or differential method, orifice plate, venturi meter, Peter tube or flow nozzle. Measurement of flow. Measurement of flow is important for laboratory work as well as for industrial application. The flow measuring devices are generally of two type, namely quantity meter and the rate meter. So let's see what are the flow measuring techniques. So the first one is the inferential type of flow meter. So in this method of measurement, the flow is not directly measured, but it is inferred from the measurement of other parameters related to flow. The other parameters may be pressure, temperature, force, displacement or velocity, etc. So various inferential method of flow measurement are, first one, variable head or differential method. So in this type of flow meter, the rate of flow is inferred from the difference in pressure across the obstruction or the construction. Then the various variable head meter are orifice plate, venturi meter, Peter tube, flow nozzle. Then the second one is the rotameter or variable area meter. So in this type of meter, the flow rate is inferred from a displacement of object that result from a balance of a weight force against a velocity force. The third one is the magnetic meter. In this type of flow meter, the flow rate is inferred from velocity of flow utilizing Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. Then the turbine meter. So in this type of meter, the velocity of flow is inferred from the rotational speed of a rotor. The rotor speed is proportional to velocity of flow through meter. Then the thermal flow meter. So in this type of flow meter, the flow rate is inferred from the rise in the temperature of a stream subjected to heat flux. Then the next one is the spiral meter. So in this type of meter, the flow rate is inferred from the pressure and the temperature oscillation. Then the positive displacement method. So the positive displacement meters are volume type of meters which capture and released a fixed volume of liquid in its stroke. So these meters counts the number of strokes or cycle of operation and gives the volume handled. Various positive displacement devices are, first one is the reciprocating piston, semi rotary piston, then the nutating disc. Then the first one is the orifice plate. So the orifice plate is orifice plates are the simple and the cheapest form of primary elements and are used more frequently than other elements for measurement of flow. So this orifice plate consists of a thin circular metal plate with a hole in it. An orifice plate is held in a pipeline between two flanges. The differential pressure across it measured to get a flow rate. So there are four types of orifice plate listed below. So concentric type, eccentric type, segmental type and the quarter inch type. So from the right side you can see the different types of the orifice plate with the image. And the orifice plate are the simplest and the cheapest form of primary element and are used more frequently than other elements of measurement of flow. The orifice plate consists of thin circular metal plate with hole in it. Orifice plate is held in a pipeline between two flanges. The differential pressure across it measured to get a flow rate. The first type of orifice plate is concentric orifice plate. So it is the most widely used orifice plate, which is made of stainless steel and its thickness is 1/8 to 1/2 inches. So varies depending on the pipe size and the flow velocity. So it has a circular hole in middle and it is installed in a pipeline with the hole concentric to pipe. It is made from other materials such as the nickel, phosphorus, bronze, etc. to withstand the corrosive effect of the fluid. Then the second one is the eccentric orifice plate. So it is similar to concentric type, but it has offset hole, which is a circle, the diameter of which is 98% of the pipe diameter. The location of the offset hole prevents damaging of a solid material or the forging particles and makes it useful for measuring fluid containing oils. The third one is the segmental orifice plate. So segmental orifice plate is placed at bottom of pipe. The opening is a segment of a circle which is 0.98 of the pipe diameter. So it is installed with the damp horizontal with the curved section of the opening coincident with the lower surface of pipe. Then the fourth one is the quadrant edge orifice plate. So this type of orifice plate is used for flows such as a heavy crude oil, syrups and the slurries and the viscous flow. So it is concentrated in such a way that the edge is the rounded to form a quarter circle. The plates has a concentric opening with a round up stream edge rather than a sharp, so square edge normally used. Advantages of orifice plate. So it have a low cost, then easy in installation and repair, can be used in a wide range of pipe size. Then it requires less space as compared with the venturi meter. Then it is available in many materials. Then what are the disadvantages of orifice plate? It causes relatively high permanent pressure loss, tends to clog those reducing used in a slurry surface, then have a squared root characteristics. Venturi meter. Venturi meter consists of straight inlet section. It is the same as the diameter of a pipe and in which the high pressure tap is located. For satisfactory operation, a straight pipe of a length equal to 5 to 10 times the diameter of inlet section is used before fitting venturi meter. A converging conical section. In converging portion, the cross section area decreases and velocity of the flow increases. The converging portion is provided with the included angle 21 degree. The pressure head decreases in this portion. Throat. So it is the cylindrical section of minimum area. So at this section the velocity is maximum and pressure is minimum. The throat diameter is 1/4 to 1/2 of inlet pipe diameter. Length of the throat is equal to its diameter. Pressure tap is provided at the throat. The fourth one is the diverging or the recovering cone. So in this section the velocity decreases and decreased velocity is recovered as a pressure head. To get the maximum recovery of energy, the diffuser section is provided with the angle 5 to 70 degree. The angle is kept low so that the fluid flow has least tendency to separate out from the boundaries of section. In order to reduce the cost and the length of a section, the angle may be increases to 14 degree. So pressure taps are located to measure the differential pressures at inlet and throat, which is used to determine a flow rate of a flowing fluid. Flow velocity through venturi meter is given by capital V is equal to A1 upon under root of A1 square minus A2 square into under root of 2 into G into H. So where capital V is the velocity of flowing fluid, small a is the area of inlet, small a2 is the area of throat, small g is the acceleration due to gravity, and small h the is difference of pressure head between inlet and throat. The next point is the Peter tube. So Peter tube is primary obstruction type element used for fluid velocity measurement. The measurement of velocity can be converted into the discharge. So it is the simplest form. It consists of a glass tube bent at a right angles near a one end having a small opening. The bent end is Peter tube placed in the flowing fluid having motion. When the liquid enters this bent tube, its kinetic energy is converted into the pressure head. Due to this liquid, the rise in tube to height small h. So this is the diagram of a Peter tube. It consists of the one pipe with the Peter tube is inserted in the pipe with having height V square into 2 into G, and the flow direction of the flow is showing in the diagram. So this is all about the Peter tube. Advantages of Peter tube. So there is a negligible loss of pressure head. It is cheaper than the venturi meter or orifice plate. It can be inserted through a small hole or into a pipe, then the limitation of the pitot tube is it cannot be used for liquids that contains the suspended solid like slurry. Its sensitivity decreases with decreasing velocity of fluid. It gives non-linear relationship of pressure and the velocity, so it is unsuitable for dirty and the sticky fluid. The next point is flow nozzle. So flow nozzle is the compromise between orifice plate and venturimeter. Flow nozzle is similar venturimeter but without diverging cone. So in general, engineering practice, it is used to create the jet of high velocity, but when it is used at the end of the pipe as measuring device is called as a flow nozzle. So in its simple form, it consists of a cone gradually decreasing diameter with smooth entry. So from diagram you can see the nozzle. So in this, the fluid flow is having the direction from the right side. So as you can see over here, and this is called as a nozzle. So it reduces the area of a pipe and increase the pressure of fluid flow. Advantages of flow nozzle. So it is a cheaper than the venturimeter. It can be installed in existing main pipe easily. As compared to venturimeter, it is a short in a length. It is useful for flow which contains solid suspension particles. Permanent pressure loss is less than of orifice plate. Then it has a high coefficient of discharge than the orifice meter. It can be used for flow of high velocity as they are more rugged. Then disadvantages of flow nozzle. First one is the pressure recovery is poor. It cannot be used where the low pressure head is available. It cannot be used for a large pipe size. More expensive and difficult to install as compared to orifice plate. Thank you.